Kumusta kayo mga kids? Week 5 na. Ang topic natin ngayon, routine and non-routine problems involving multiplication without or with addition or subtraction of decimals and whole numbers including money. Handa ka na bang matuto? So after going through this lesson, you are expected to solve routine and non-routine problems involving multiplication without or with addition or subtraction of decimals and whole numbers including money using appropriate problem solving strategies and tools. Answer the given problem. Piolo and his friends ordered 2 chicken sandwiches, 3 cheeseburgers, and 1 ham and egg sandwich. How much did they pay? For cheeseburger, 25 pesos and 50 centavos each. Chicken sandwich, 75 pesos and 25 centavos each. Ham and egg sandwich, 55 pesos and 75 centavos each. Para malaman natin kung magkano ang tatlong cheeseburgers, i-multiply natin sa 3. So, let's multiply. 3 times 0 equals 0. 3 times 5 equals 15. 3 times 5 plus 1 equals 16. 3 times 2 plus 1 equals 7. So, ang tatlong cheeseburgers ay 76 pesos and 50 centavos. For chicken sandwich, i-multiply natin ito sa 2. Let's multiply. 2 times 5 equals 10. 2 times 2 plus 1 equals 5. 2 times 5 equals 10. And 2 times 7 plus 1 equals 15. So, 2 chicken sandwiches, that is 150 pesos and 50 centavos. Sa ham and egg sandwich ay pareho lang. So, para makuha natin kung magkano lahat ang babayaran, let us add 76 pesos and 50 centavos, 150 pesos and 50 centavos, 55 pesos and 75 centavos. Let us add. 0 plus 0 plus 5 equals 5. 5 plus 5 plus 7 equals 17. 1 plus 6 plus 5 equals 12. 1 plus 7 plus 5 plus 5 equals 18. And 1 plus 1 equals 2. So, ang kanyang babayaran lahat ay 282 pesos and 75 centavos. Study the given problem. Look for the solution and answer the questions that follows. Mang Isko has 28 pesos and 56 centavos. If he has to divide it into his 6 children, how much will each one receive? To understand, let us know what is asked, that is the amount of money each child will receive. Know the given facts, 28 pesos and 56 centavos and 6 children. For plan, determine the operation to be used, that is division. Write the number sentence, 28 pesos and 56 centavos divided by 6 equals n. To solve, I will show to you solution, 28 pesos and 56 centavos divided by 6. So, since ang divisor ay walang decimal point, ang dividend ay may decimal point, itataas lang ang decimal point. Then, let us divide like whole number. 28 divided by 6, that is 4. 4 times 6, 24. 28 minus 24, equals 4. Bring down 5. 45 divided by 6, and that is 7. 7 times 6, 42. 45 minus 42 equals 3. Bring down 6. 36 divided by 6 equals 6. 6 times 6 equals 36. And 36 minus 36 equals 0. So, 28 pesos and 56 centavos divided by 6 equals 4 pesos and 76 centavos. To check and look back, review and recheck your answer, you may use calculator to divide 28 pesos and 56 centavos by 6 or multiply 4 pesos and 76 centavos by 6. Therefore, each child receives 4 pesos and 76 centavos. Learning task 1. Solve the given problems. Write your answers in your notebook. Larry drinks an average of 6 and 4/800 glasses of water per day. About how many glasses of water will he drink in a week, a month, a year, a decade? Sagutan natin, in a week. When you say about how many, ito ay estimation. Ibig sabihin, ang learning task 1 ay review ng previous lesson. So, 6 and 4/800. I-multiply natin ito sa 7. Pero bago yan, estimate muna natin ng mga factors. So, ang katabi ng 6 ay 4. Round down, it becomes 6. And dati lang ang 7. So, 6 times 7, that is 42. Ibig sabihin, in a week, 42 glasses of water. For number 2, in a month, same given, 6 and 4/800, but this time, we will multiply in 30 days. I round off, ang 6 and 4/800, magiging itong 6, then copy 30. Let's multiply 6 times 30. Okay, shortcut, bring down 0. Then, 3 times 6 equals 18. So, in a month, 180 glasses of water. For learning task 2, copy the table below, write your answers in your notebook. Here's the table. For medicine A, for 1 person, 7 pesos. Magkano para sa 5 persons? 7 pesos times 5 equals 35 pesos. Magkano naman para sa 14 persons? So, just multiply 7 pesos times 14. For medicine B, for 5 persons, 60 pesos and 60 centavos. Magkano para sa 1 person? So, 60 pesos and 60 centavos divided by 5, and that is 12 pesos and 12 centavos. Magkano para sa 14 persons? Just multiply 12 pesos and 12 centavos times 14. For medicine C, for 14 persons, that is 213 pesos and 50 centavos, magkano para sa isang tao? So, 213 pesos and 50 centavos divided by 14, and that is 15 pesos and 25 centavos. Para sa limang tao, just multiply 15 pesos and 25 centavos times 5. Alam kong kayang-kaya na ninyo itong sagutan. For learning task 3, solve the following problems. Write your solutions and your answers in your notebook. For number 1, school lunches cost 135 pesos and 50 centavos per week. About how much would 15 and 5/10 weeks of lunches cost? Solution, 135 pesos and 50 centavos times 15 and 5/10. So let's multiply. We multiply ang first digit na 5. 5 times 0 equals 0. 5 times 5, 25. 5 times 5 plus 2 equals 27. 5 times 3 plus 2 equals 17. 5 times 1 plus 1 equals 6. Then, multiply ang second digit na 5. 5 times 0 is 0. 5 times 5, 25. 5 times 5 plus 2 equals 27. 5 times 3 plus 2 equals 17. 5 times 1 plus 1 equals 6. Then, multiply ang digit na 1. 1 times 0, 0. 1 times 5 is 5. 1 times 5, 5. 1 times 3 is 3. And 1 times 1 equals 1. Then, i-add lahat ang partial products. Bring down 0. 5 plus 0 is 5. 7 plus 5 plus 0 equals 12. 1 plus 7 plus 7 plus 5 equals 20. 2 plus 6 plus 7 plus 5 equals 20. 2 plus 6 plus 3 equals 11. And 1 plus 1 equals 2. So, ang multiplicand ay 2 decimal places. Ang multiplier ay 1 decimal place. Therefore, ang product natin ay 3 decimal places. Para malagay ng decimal point, bumilang tayo ng 3 mula sa kanan pakaliwa at ilagay ang decimal point. Kaya naman ang ating sagot ay 2,100 pesos and 25 centavos. For problem number 2, Lorna earns 71 pesos and 75 centavos per hour for gardening. If she will work for 21 hours this month, then how much will she earn? For solution, 71 pesos and 75 centavos times 21. So let's multiply. 1 times 5 equals 5. 1 times 7, 7. 1 times 1 equals 1. 1 times 7 equals 7. Then multiply ang digit na 2. 2 times 5 equals 10. 2 times 7 plus 1 equals 15. 2 times 1 plus 1 equals 3. And 2 times 7 equals 14. Then, i-add natin ang 2 partial products. Bring down 5. 7 plus 0 is 7. 1 plus 5 equals 6. 7 plus 3 equals 10. 1 plus 4 equals 5. And 1, bring down. So, ang multiplicand ay 2 decimal places. Ang multiplier ay 0 decimal place. Kaya naman, ang ating product ay 2 decimal places. So, ang ating sagot ay 1,506 pesos and 75 centavos. Maraming salamat muli sa inyong panonood. Hanggang sa susunod natin mga videos. Paalam!